Hello everyone, I'm Caleb with Danzy Design Build. Super excited to be here with you doing this video today, testing a basement walkout drain. Recently, we've got a lot of comments from our YouTube subscribers or viewers. Who knows if they've even subscribed? You should consider. But wondering if we should like up our drain sizes and make them more robust and just more bulletproof. Well, we do already think our drains are very bulletproof. And today we're going to show you the math and the nerdy details behind how we've come to design our drains this way and why they work for our area in the desert in Utah. So let's just jump right in. All right, so now we need to get to the math about how to calculate how much water we are anticipating in this walkout entry. So Utah is the second driest state in the country, so we don't get very much rainfall to begin with. On average, we get 13 inches per year of rainfall. The rainiest month that we've had was 2.6 inches of rain in the entire month. And that was in the last, roughly the last two decades. So that's what we're calculating off of, is 2.6 inches per month. So what we're going to need to do is multiply the width of the walkout entry times the length of it. So this one is 4.5 feet wide times 15 feet long, and that's 67 square feet. And so we multiply that by the rainfall that we get in a month. So 2.6 inches per month, that's 175 square inches deep of rainfall. So we're going to multiply that by 0.623 to convert that to gallons. And that gives us 109 gallons of rainfall in that rainy month. So we'll divide that by an assumption of, we'll just assume 9 rainstorms in that month. That would be every 3 days a pretty good storm. So divide that by 9 equals 12.14 gallons of rainwater in a really rainy month in our state of Utah. So that's what we need to make sure that this drain can safely store before it floods or something. So now we get to jump into the fun part of actually testing this walkout drain. So we've got our hose set up to simulate a rainstorm, and we basically need to figure out how many gallons per minute are coming out of this hose. So let's do a little test here with a 5 gallon bucket and see how long that's going to take. All right, so we've set up our garden hose to simulate a rainstorm that's going on. We've got it set to fill up a 5 gallon bucket in 9 minutes. So if we do 9 minutes divided by 5 gallons, that is 1.8 minutes per gallon. So we need 12 gallons, 12.14. So we'll multiply that 1.8 times 12.14. And that is 21.85 minutes of this garden hose running at this rate that the walkout will need to be able to withstand to be equal to one of these heavy rainstorms. So we'll let this go for 21.85 minutes and see how it does. All right, so we just hit the 22 minute mark here, pouring this water down the drain, and it made it. We didn't have any problems with it flooding. So by our calculations, this will definitely last and withstand the worst month, or one of the worst storms in the one of the worst months in the last two decades. So this walkout drain is doing great. So now at this point, we're just gonna take some 5 gallon buckets and just dump it straight down and just see with a massive storm like that, how we're doing. So here we go. All right, so now we've made it past that, we're gonna go for the second 5 gallon bucket. All right, now we're on to bucket number 3. Okay, we've made it through 3 buckets, now we're gonna go for a 4th one. All right, so we've just put down 32 gallons of water into this walkout entry drain, and it's handling it just fine. We only calculated we needed to have 12 gallons go down for like a record year with a really wet storm, a lot of water. So we're doing really good. 32 gallons is plenty for this, and we're just gonna stop there because we feel like we're actually wasting water today. So the type of drain we put in this walkout was the type with the gravel and the 5 gallon bucket in the middle. That's the style that we did on this walkout drain. And we actually put 2 feet deep of gravel, 2 feet wide, and basically two feet cubed of gravel, and then the 5 gallon bucket in the middle of that. And then this is how it's performing. So just wanted to let you guys know this really does work. If you're still concerned about water table rising or some crazy events happening, we can definitely accommodate that. There are electric pumps that we can use and install those. They do cost a little bit more just because of the pump and the electrical and the plumbing that's associated with it. But those are totally an option as well. So if you're looking to remodel your home, build a basement apartment or finish your basement, build a basement walkout entry and have a really good drain in it, we can definitely help you with any of those things. Designing your basement, drawing plans, and doing everything from idea all the way through planning, the city permitting, construction, all the way through the end. So if you need any help with any of those things, you can reach us on our website, danzydesignbuild.com, and schedule a consultation there. Thank you for your time today, and have a great week. We'll talk to you later. Bye.